If you can make whatever you're building achieve the simplicity and the understanding and the usability of a light switch, you've won. A two-year-old walks up to a light switch and they flip it and they get it from the minute they see it. They're like, okay, if I touch that, that thing goes on. As I was building a couple of just like hobby projects, it was a pretty enlightening moment when I was like, I could probably use my presence to turn on lights. A lot of my background was in using data to make decisions. It was very clear that the home was becoming a place where data was going to become very important, and there was a lot of really cool use cases that you can solve. I started to think, what are the companies who would be very interesting to start to explore this space? And then, of course, Google was the first that came to mind, and the next thing I needed to do was figure out how to get here. Mark Spates, and I lead product management for smart speakers at Google. When you walk in a room and you have very curious, intelligent people who are willing to challenge ideas and challenge norms, that type of culture leads to amazing products and amazing user experiences and solving real user problems. Machine learning, AI, natural language understanding. We've been investing in this stuff 10 years now. And so what you're finally starting to see is some of this investment in core technology come to a new form factor, which are the smart speakers, smart displays, and learning thermostats and things like that. Google Home, the first one, the speaker, it was just the first iteration. Now we have Nest learning thermostats that are there with us. We have the Google Home Hub. We have things like the Nest Hello doorbell. It's about solving users' problems, and Google has always been about that. Let's look at those habitual habits and let's see if we can make those either more efficient, better, or even more delightful. The context in the home, the topology of the home is extremely important, right? What are you doing? Who is there? What things are there? What capabilities do these things have? I think it's important for us to understand that it's not about us deciding, it's about the user deciding. The user chooses to bring these different products in their home. And the number one thing we can do as Google is make sure that we work with those products. Google can't make everything, so partners are extremely important. If you think about a home, like you have like washers and dryers, you have like refrigerators, you have a heating system, you have all these other awesome furniture that you bought, right? So homes have a lot of diverse things that you bring into them. And so for us, the partners help us bring some of the core use cases to life. At each step, we're taking a user problem and we're saying, what's the hardware, what's the software, and what's the artificial intelligence that we can combine together to solve that user problem in the home? If you walk around Google Campus, you'll see that there is a recycle bin every 3 or 4 steps. You'll see that everyone's encouraged to make sure you use like the recycled items at the cafe. There's parks. There's greenery. It's always in the background, so it's something that's always really easy for everyone to rally around of like, how are we building these things to make sure that we're leaving a better place, a better planet, and how can we be more sustainable about this? And it is built into the overall product development process. The thing that we're starting to learn is that unlike other consumer electronics, a lot of the devices that we are making in the homes, they're usually not replacements, they're additive. I get a new one and I may move the old one to the hallway. I get a new one, I may move the old one to the guest bedroom. So even the way we design the devices are very much more like furniture than they are consumer electronics because the sustainability is aligned with the lifetime of a device. So sustainability is not just about the recyclability of it, it's also about the livability of it. Find a user problem that you're passionate about. Core user problems, you may solve them in different ways, but as you identify them and it's something that you're passionate about solving, I think that is a journey for your career. Build something, ship something. It's always been my mantra and it's always seemed to kind of work out. Even if you take kind of different paths, it always seemed to work out. Don't think about it. Bias to action. Do something.